Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, well, my number five is also quite fun. It's a game called Kitty Powers Matchmaker on iOS.
I saw this at EGX.
Yeah, that, I mean, it was a listener recommendation last week, the early part of last week, and I looked at it and I was like, that's got to be a joke. But then I started reading people finding it at Eurogamer and saying it was really, really good. So I downloaded it. It's about £2. Wow, I don't know where to begin. There's so much to say about how the game actually works that I'll try and keep that sort of... Basically, the game involves you being a new matchmaker working for this person called Kitty Powers, and her job, she's a matchmaker. She has, like, this dating agency, and she has to put couples together. And you have to match like-minded people. It kind of reminded me of that movie Roxanne with Steve Martin, because you're coaching your clients through how to succeed on these things, and sometimes right. you encourage them to lie, etc., etc. If you want to try and get them to impress their date, you have to try and you have to lie, convince them to lie, and then you have to pass a mini. You know, it's a mini game compilation basically. Mm. If you want them to lie, a Wheel of Fortune thing comes up, and it's a mini game. And if you fail that, they don't believe you, and that's going to help the prospects on the date. You can also do the person you're with can also do things like disappear halfway through a meal at a restaurant, and then they can come back and go, hey, I fixed my style emergency. How do I look? And you have to identify what's changed about them, so it's like spot the difference. And you just have to keep... You have three opportunities to find each person a date. Otherwise, they leave your company and go and go to another dating agency. And once you've made a couple, they send you messages about their relationship. They send you letters, and good ones. If, hey, we got married, we've had kids, A+, then you get sent some extra points, etc. And as you keep succeeding, you expand your salon so that you can style people's hair before a date to make them sort of fit the specs of what the person's looking for. And you can also get more affluent clients who want to sort of visit swankier restaurants where the puzzles are a little bit more difficult. It is basically a very, very amusing mini game compilation. So it's spot the difference puzzles and all sorts of random things. There was one game where I was sitting at the dinner table, or rather the person I was trying to get a date, and he started getting gas and he was like, I can't break wind. So in order to stop him farting at the table, I had to play like a higher or lower card game, like higher than the queen. And if you fail that, then he breaks wind and hurts the chances. It's loads and loads of stuff like that. It looks good. It's really well animated. I mean, there are a couple of flaws. I mean, after you've played it for a little while, you notice that you can't be honest about your job if you have a shit job. 99% of your people, if you're a bus driver and you say bus driver, then they're like, right, I suppose that's something. You know, they get.
Right.
You have to lie. That's one of those questions in which you always have to lie. Because they always just think your job is wank. So that doesn't change until you start getting the more affluent customers and start expanding your business. So it's a game that's supposed to last quite a long time, and it's pretty good. I mean, it's actually very good, in fact. I mean, it's the kind of thing that's... It's kind of in a weird sort of halfway house between being a game you can play in short bursts and a game that's meant to be played over a long period of time. So it's not quite a game you can pick up and play, because going out to a meal and all that, so doing all the bits and pieces takes probably about 5 minutes each time, okay. which is a short amount of time. But I suppose I'm comparing it to something like Angry Birds or something like that. But I wasn't expecting to like this. I thought people were winding me up, but it's genuinely well made, and it's amusing, and very weird also. Very tantalisingly weird, but it's good. I recommend it. It's £2 on iOS. I played it on an iPad. I'm sure it'll work great on iPhone as well. Get it.